Hi, let's talk about the nerves of the superior mediastinum and root of the neck. Previously, we've discussed the carotid sheath and its major constituents, namely the common carotid artery, the internal jugular vein, and the vagus nerve, or cranial nerve 10. We can see the vagus nerve descending down. It's leaving the jugular foramen, and it remains within the carotid sheath down through the root of the neck, and it will continue on down towards the roots of the lungs, where it passes posterior to the roots of the lungs, and it's going to contribute branches along the way to many structures, important structures in the soft palate, as well as the neck and the thorax, and ultimately will head into the abdominal cavity to supply the foregut and the midgut with preganglionic parasympathetics. At the root of the neck on the right side, the vagus nerve is going to send a major branch called the recurrent laryngeal nerve. That recurrent laryngeal nerve wraps around the right subclavian artery and heads towards the tracheoesophageal groove, where it is going to ascend along with the inferior laryngeal artery to supply the larynx with innervation. It will be motor innervation to all of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles, with the exception of the cricothyroid muscle. It's going to return somatic sensory information from the mucosa of the larynx inferior to the vocal folds, and it will also supply visceromotor or preganglionic parasympathetic fibers to the mucosa of the larynx inferior to the vocal folds. On the right side, we can see the vagus nerve coming down here. It's going to send the right recurrent laryngeal nerve around the concavity of the aorta, and it's going to ascend in that tracheoesophageal groove there. Now, both the right and the left recurrent laryngeal nerves are going to send branches to the cardiac plexuses. The left for the superficial cardiac plexus, and both the left and the right to the deep cardiac plexus, which can be found deep to the arch of the aorta and superficial or anterior to the trachea. We can also see in this image the phrenic nerves as they traverse the superior mediastinum on the way down to innervate the diaphragm. The phrenic nerves originate from the cervical plexus. The cervical plexus consists of contribution of ventral primary rami of cervical nerves 1 through 4. And it also arises slightly from the brachial plexus. The brachial plexus consists of ventral primary rami of cervical nerves 5 through 8 and T1. Now, the phrenic nerve roots are VPRs of C3, 4, and 5. And the mnemonic goes, C3, 4, 5 keeps the diaphragm alive, because the phrenic nerve is going to innervate the diaphragm, or the hemidiaphragm, because there are two of them. Here we can see the phrenic nerve descending down through the root of the neck, just anterior to that anterior scalene muscle here, crossing over some of the branches from the thyrocervical trunk, namely the transverse cervical artery here and the suprascapular artery there. And we can see that that phrenic nerve then dives deep. So it's going to be between the anterior scalene muscle and what would be the subclavian vein over here, as it descends down into the thorax. So we've discussed the two major nerves of the root of the neck and superior mediastinum. the phrenic nerve, which is more lateral, and the vagus nerve, which we can see here, which is more medial. And the vagus nerve additionally will have recurrent laryngeal nerve branches in this region. Thank you very much for your time.